Hello students, I am Anwar Ahmed on behalf of ASCII Literature, and the topic that we are covering today is Of Revenge by Sir Francis Bacon. Of Revenge, as the name suggests, is about a revengeful person who thinks to take revenge from an enemy. Sir Francis Bacon, in didactic tone, talks about merits and demerits of revenge. The essay is full of wisdom, but it is of a strange kind. He gives examples from the past, quotes opinions of philosophers, and uses allusions to clear his point of view. This essay, although has morality, yet it is limited to worldly wisdom. Revenge and its cons. He starts his essay while saying revenge is a kind of wild justice. Firstly, he tries to convince every revengeful person not to take revenge. But if someone has decided to take it, then he should adopt a legal method. In his eyes, breaking the law is not a rational act. Moreover, a person should do his best to forgive the bad deeds of his enemy. By doing so, he will get two benefits. One of them is moral superiority. Forgiveness makes a person noble. He quotes the wise words of Solomon, who said, "It is the glory of a man to pass by an offense." Secondly, a loss is lost forever. Revenge cannot recover a loss. Moreover, wise men do not think about past. They concentrate on the present and future. Why people harm others? There are certain reasons due to which people harm others. Profit, pleasure, and honor. All these acts show the selfishness of a person. If a person is selfish, then not everyone should follow him. Sir Francis Bacon here suggests that a revengeful person should ignore him. He does not need to keep a selfish person in his mind for the whole of his life, as by doing so, he just wastes his time. There is also another reason due to which people harm others: ill nature. If a person is of ill nature, then it is better to ignore him. Bacon calls him thorn or barrier, which only pricks and scratches. He cannot damage a person at the largest level. Therefore, there is no need to think about an ill-natured person. In which condition a person can take revenge? There is a situation when a person can take revenge from his enemy. Where the law does not provide any remedy, a person can take revenge. However, precautions should be kept in mind. Firstly, he should keep in mind that law does not go against him. Otherwise, he will still be at disadvantage as compared to his enemy. Moreover, identity should be revealed while doing any harm to an enemy. The true meaning of revenge lies in seeing the miserable condition of the victim. Revenge can only be completed in case the enemy repents on his wrongdoings. He should know that why harm is being done to him. And it is possible only if the revengeful person has revealed his identity to his enemy. A person who does not reveal his identity while taking revenge is a coward in the eyes of Sir Francis Bacon. Anyone is pardonable, but not friends. Sir Francis Bacon has deeply studied Cosmas, Duke of Florence, and Job. He quotes their words. Cosmas has said that anyone is forgivable but an unfaithful friend. "It is unwise to pardon an unfaithful friend," said Cosmas. Job, on the other hand, thinks the opposite. He has said that if a person obtains benefits from friends, then he should forgive them for their misconducts. Sir Francis Bacon supports Job in this regard, instead of Cosmas. We can witness the worldly wisdom of Sir Francis Bacon. If a person gets favor from his friends, then it is necessary for him to ignore the disloyalty of his friends. Why revenge is harmful? First of all, it wastes time. Secondly, it keeps vengeful person's wounds fresh. Thirdly, it mentally tortures him, as he always thinks of doing harm to his enemy. Therefore, he lives a miserable life. Bacon calls this kind of life the life of witches. However, there are some revenges which are necessary to be taken. Bacon named them public revenges. Supports his assertions by referring a public revenge from Roman history. Julius Caesar was assassinated for the murder of Pertinax and Henry III of France. Another kind of revenge is private revenge. Public revenges are for the most part fortunate, but in private revenges it is not, said Sir Francis Bacon. Cleven. Bacon highly criticizes a revengeful person. He suggests that he should either forget his past or ignore his enemy. Otherwise, he is going to live a miserable life. Nevertheless, we see Bacon's worldly approach. The essay is moral in nature, but nowhere in the essay is morality related to spirituality. This essay is only thoughtful from worldly perspectives rather than religious perspectives. Bacon adds relevant quotations of ancient philosophers and makes his essay rich. The advice of not taking revenge, which Sir Francis Bacon gives to his readers, is not new, but his arguments and references makes it fresh. Indeed, this essay is worth reading, especially it is dedicated to those persons who are living an unhappy life while having revenge in their minds. That's all for today, guys. See you in the next video.